You may have heard of spring, summer, autumn and winter, but did you know Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people have their own names and times for their seasons? Our knowledge is unique to each community and their environment and has been passed down through generation to generation for over 65,000 years. Welcome to Many Lands, Many Seasons. This is the mighty Martuwarra Fitzroy River, which winds through the town to Fitzroy Crossing, 400 kilometres inland from Broome, Western Australia.
Welcome to Fitzroy Valley District High School.
The Fitzroy Valley District High School is on Bunuba country, and just across the river is Gooniyandi country.
Hello, my name is Mamindji Han. I'm a Walmajarri language teacher at Fitzroy Valley District High School, but I actually coordinate the whole language program which our school have running, and there are three languages, Walmajarri, Bunuba and Gooniyandi. And we're now out on our learning on country as part of our language program at school.
The students are heading to Dungulgeeky Gorge on the Fitzroy River. They're travelling upstream to Crocodile Creek. As well as learning local Aboriginal languages, the students are also discovering the importance of learning seasonal knowledge.
Our scientists are old people. We learn off them. They tell us what time to pick food and hunt, you know, go fishing and go hunting. My name's Mary Aiken. My Aboriginal name, Ngambaramia. My skin is Nagara. And my moi, my country, is Dangu.
In Walmajarri, we have three seasons: Baranga, Itilal, and Magura. Itilal, rainy season; Baranga, hot time; and Magura, cold weather. The flowers let us know when other animals or food is available. Like when the kurumba, the paperbark tree, flowers, it's time to start collecting the gaguru, freshwater mussel, because the flowers and their nectar drop into the water and feed the gaguru, making them nice and tasty. At the end of Baranga, the white flowers of the buluru, the crocodile tree tells us that guarnia, the freshwater crocs, are laying the eggs. These eggs will be ready for us to collect in Itilal, the rainy season. Itilal is also good fishing time because the river is high and the billabongs and the creeks are full.
This time of the year is what, you know, you call winter, but we call it magura season. And the fishes that we get here at this time of the year, balga, which is barramundi, goes off the bite. But other little fish like the black brim or sooty grunter, which is jamanburu in Walmajarri. We get the archer fish, marbol in Walmajarri, and other fishes like the bony brim that we caught this morning for bait. And if you look behind us, as you can see, our majala tree, which has got flowers on it. And it's telling us that, you know, we are going into the magura season. So the flowers are starting to bloom. And that particular bush we use when we catch catfish, gulumajeri in Walmajarri, it's got these spikes on it. And we, if you're unlucky, if you get stung or poked by a catfish, we use that particular tree to ease the pain away, take the pain away. So it's one of the bush medicine that we use on the river.
In Magura, cold weather time, some gagaji or goannas will stay in their burrows until when the first storm comes.
The Gooniyandi people also have three main seasons in their seasonal calendar.
This season now is Mungwala. In Gooniyandi we call it the Mungwala season, cold weather. and it's up and down the weather. And at this time we don't catch many fish because of the Mongol, and it's very cold. Only certain fish like the black bream, jumping burrow we catch here. There's balga, jaliji, lari, girwali, all these traditional name for the our fish. People in the cold weather, people love going out for jaliji. That's our freshwater prawn. Walmajarri people call it jaramba. In our language, we say jaliji. So the kids, today they caught lots of jaliji.
We're just waiting for the cones to come so we can put it in the cones. Just like from the shops, except better.
As well as freshwater prawn and bream, long-necked turtles are common in this part of the river too.
He's a pretty big one.
Oh. You letting it go?
Our Bunuba seasonal calendar has four seasons. Bullaroo is the wet season. The first storms from the south bring lightning, thunder and big gusty winds. Quieter eastern storms bring lots of windy rain and flooding rivers. The country is green with drinking water everywhere, allowing us to travel across country harvesting animals and plants. The country is at its most alive and active during Girinbong. Balga is swimming back upstream to the permanent waters. The gilini appears during wet season when the bright yellow flowers appear. This indicates that the bani are fat and ready to be hunted. The bani are actively hunting for frogs and getting fat in Girinbong. Winter rains called galawa knock down the mangaloo speargrass, signalling cold weather. When bundrel ngari, silver leaf paperbarks, are flowering, it's baranga, hot weather season. Gai lay their eggs in sandy riverbanks, hatching when mala, freshwater mangrove, flowers.
It's been a fun day on Crocodile Creek, catching and cooking fish and learning about the different seasons. Do you mob have a favourite season?
My favourite season is flood time because you get to fish more.
Mongowala, and that is the cold season because I like when it rains and I like wearing my jumpers because they have more use in the cold season.
Ziyadala, which is the rainy season because when it's high floods, you can get fish from anywhere you like.
Voila. And yeah.
Next, it's back to the classroom to draw some of the animals that live in the Martuwarra Fitzroy River.
Hi, my name is William Munro, and this is a barramundi. In Walmajarri, we call this balga.
Hi, my name is Leonard, and this is jaramba.
Hello, my name is Faith, and I drew a water owl, and in English, it's turtle.
My name is Eli, this is a bush turkey, and one of our, we call it galamara.
Having a language program, it teaches them about our cultural knowledge, transferring the knowledge across to our children, and it's really important to the kids to understand about the country, understanding the cultural knowledge about, you know, how our old people used to live and survive, even in the river area or in the desert or wherever our people came from.
It is an important knowledge, so that when they grow up and they'll remember what we've told them when they're kids, you know, to save the environment and environment that our, like, turkey and guana are living in.
Auntie Mary is making sure she passes on this knowledge to her granddaughter Letitia to ensure it's not lost to future generations.
This one here, when the end of the season, end of the year, this one starts flowering. It tells you that crocodiles preparing their nests on the sand. They come up here on the sand, and when the river runs, and the first rainfall. Because when that rain falls, it makes the sand very hot and ready for the little ones to hatch.
As a young leader in my community and in my school, I believe that it's really, really important that you learn from old people because they have so much knowledge and there's power in knowledge. Know about all the things of your country. Without that, I wouldn't know who I am or where I come from.
I hope you've enjoyed exploring Fitzroy Valley and learning about the local Aboriginal languages and seasonal calendars. I'll leave it to Letitia to say goodbye.
Yaninja or goodbye from the Dangu mob of Fitzroy Valley.